It's all good, Spidey. Don't worry about it.
Hey, sorry I'm late.
Morning, Parker. Or is it evening? That doesn't matter. Check the neurosensors, would you? We need a faster response time.
On it.
Try to get it under 3 milliseconds.
What is this, Doc? Never seen this type of material.
Would you believe it's for welding? Provides remarkable magnetic insulation and limits cross-contamination between the neural interface and arms.
Doc loves these things. He used them in grad school when he had to manipulate radioactive isotopes. Says seeing them keeps him humble. Ugh. How do you know we lost our grant money? Just taste the new coffee.
How's it going, Peter?
The device will need two parts to function. The first will be an entirely original prosthesis, a modular system of microcables able to take on any number of forms, whatever the user can imagine. The second part, and this, Peter, is the true genius, is a direct neural interface, a direct tap straight into the basal ganglia. Unleash the brain, from your mind to reality. This goes beyond limb replacement, Peter. This will free all of us from the shackles of our bodies. Like your web friend, soon we'll all be capable of living our most amazing fantasies.
Waiting on you, Parker.
What was Doc working on with this? Beautiful. Looks like another potential prosthetic contact material. Oh, hydrogel IPN. This looks promising. Bet it'd be a great tissue interface. What was Doc working on with this? Thank you. Great conductivity. Not sure about long-term wear and tear, though. Might delaminate easily. Doc was testing the biocompatibility of graphene. Pretty high cytotoxicity. Not sure I'd use this as tissue interface. Running tests on carbon nanotube biocompatibility. Decent candidate for a direct tissue interface, but I feel like we can do better. Graphene. But the structure is super unique. What is this? Awesome! It's been nano-latticed. Wow, that's strong. Could be a great structural element for a prosthetic. Doc's messing around with superconductors. Thank you. Very cool. Complex oxide ceramic. Perfect type 2 superconductor. It'll run hot, but maybe good for an outboard controller? Some kind of polymer. Self-healing polymer. This stuff will survive almost anything. Let's take a look. Did it! Time for some science. That looks right. Okay, looks like I could optimize this power relay.
Nice. Okay, what next? Looks like some impedance in this neurosensor circuit. Finished. Signal to noise is out of whack. A new signal processor should reduce lag.
I got it, Doc. 2.8 milliseconds.
Good work, Peter.
I'd call that a mild success.
I'd call that unbelievable. Do you need some help?
Yes.
Doctor, what's going on?
It's become that obvious. My doctors call it a degenerative neurological disorder. Probably caused by overexposure to toxic chemicals in my reckless youth.
Sorry, is there anything I can do?
You already are. The worst part is, it only affects the muscles. The mind continues to work, but it can no longer do. You're the only one who knows, Peter. I'd like to keep it that way.
Of course.
If you'd like to seek a position with more of a future.
I came here to work for you because of what you've got up here. And that's not going anywhere. So neither am I.
Oh, Peter, before I forget, I read the most fascinating article. Outlines possible next steps for the neural interface.
I'll take a look. Thanks, Doc.
Man, I remember the first day I had direct interface with the basal ganglia. Exciting, but risky.
I don't know, Doc. You'll need a gallium silk array to make it work. Even then, odds of injury are pretty high.
Gallium! Genius! Never mind the risks. We'll work them out in time.
Doc's really sick. At this rate, he'll lose control of his motor functions within a year. And if we're not careful, an intracranial implant could make things even worse. Even alter his personality. We need to proceed carefully.
Doc, I'm sorry. My aunt just texted.
No worries, Peter. I was thinking of taking a break myself. As soon as I check our telemetry data.
Thanks. I'll be back in a few hours. Hi, May.
Let me guess. Running late?
Nope, I'm actually on my way now. Have you heard from Miles?
No, but his mother said he was coming, so...
Good. I'll be there soon. Bye.